catalpa wood, otherwise known as bean tree or cigar tree. Binomial catalpa bignonoides, southern catalpa. Nice quarter grain surface. This billet might be a tad thick.
It's okay.
a little bit of a sweep in it. Take a little bit too much off. thin down that handle. Have taken a little more off of the axe, but no matter. Looks like it's about to rain on me. Take more off the top of that handle. Thank you. don't need too big a, too deep a bowl on this one. Since it's a eating spoon, hence the thin. Backside. That's the roughed out spoon ready to dry. Once it loses all its moisture, then you can do your finishing cuts. Could have made the handle thinner, but that's okay. That's a demonstration. Form's a little wonky, but you get the idea. Of course, that's a spoon out of a flat billet. But you can also get these really fun spoons out of crooks, tree branches, where you get contiguous grain. And you can actually get these crazy curves. There's a really big one. All of these are catalpa. Really nice wood to carve, but being that it's ring porous, you have to be careful with it. But once it dries, it's really quite strong. And interestingly, it does not fuzz up in water. Some woods are worse to do that than others, but catalpa doesn't do that at all. So they make great cooking spoons. Or eating spoons, or anything, you know, you would typically do with a spoon. In any event, there's your leisurely summer's afternoon carving a spoon.